Hello everyone, I am Menaka, student of M.Tech AMBS from Punjab University, Patiala. Today we are going to cover web analytics. These are the topics we will be covered in this video. The first one is search analytics, in which there are three topics: internal search, SEO and PPC. Next one is measuring email and multi-channel marketing. Third one is segmentation. Fourth one is competitive intelligence. And the fifth one is Web Analytics 2.0. The first topic, search analytics. Internal search, SEO, and PPC. Performing internal site search analytics. The term search is commonly associated with external searches, searches that happen outside your website. Many of you are doing at least a little bit of pay-per-click, that is PPC. That can be called as search engine marketing, and some of you are already gone through search engine optimization, that is SEO. Both of these efforts will drive traffic to the website from external search engines. That external search engines may be Google, Yahoo, Amazon, etc. And internal site search occurs when someone visits your website and uses its search feature to find information. Surprisingly, very few companies pay more attention to the search behavior within their own website. Even companies that are extremely sophisticated with external search campaigns, that internal site search as a stepchild and miss the opportunity to cull insights from their own website search analytics. We will be starting with understand the value of the internal search. Actually, every one of us might have done the searching in Google, Yahoo, or Amazon. So that kind of searching is actually an external search. But when you go on to Amazon or Flipkart or some kind of shopping cart website, you can see there will be one more search option in that website in order to search particular product or something from that website. So that kind of searching is called internal search. So understanding the value of the internal search, why we are going with the internal search option. A simple Google search for metrics seems to indicate a consensus that at least 10% of visitors to any given website are using internal site searches as their primary mode of navigating the website. However, this method of finding information is likely to increase for several reasons. As external search engines continue to gain traction as a method of finding information on the www, there is a likelihood that searchers will find information by the same method after they arrive at your site. In addition to the behavioral correlation between external and internal searches, there are factors at the site level that promote this behavior. As websites are becoming increasingly larger and more complex, the task of finding information becomes more efficient just by entering a query in a site search box. Example, in Amazon, when we are searching something in the Google, it will display more options. But when you click on some particular product, for example, headset, and then if you go on to Amazon shopping cart, then there you can see multiple products. So in that Amazon website, you can give some brand name or some other, there will be more categories, or you can sort out by the brand name. But instead of that, if you want to get only Sony headset, then when you are giving that option in the internal search text box in the Amazon website, that particular products will be displayed over there. So that is the explained here. In many websites are not designed to be customer centric, either because they serve one size fits all static content or because they have a suboptimal design. Some website owners or designers have obviously realized this, and internal search now dominates the core navigational element of the site. Internal site search is not optimized on many top websites. This causes customers to simply exit after a quick search. There is currently a distinct lack of understanding of the value of the internal search and how it can be used to both improve the customer experience on the site and at the same time help in clients' website outcomes. This is one of the sample example for one of the web outcomes, Razor web analytics blog. This shows a good amount of traffic from external search engines and some expected and unexpected key phrases. This is for the Occam Stresser web analytics blog search result. Here you can see the particular keywords that customers had searched on the website. Internal site search is of paramount importance both to you and your site's visitors. External searches have nothing to do with internal searches. The two sets of keywords have nothing in common because visitor intentions are radically different. If you are doing a search engine optimization only for external key phrases, you are not solving for visitors on your website. In this diagram, you can see top internal search key phrases for which customers search on the website. So this report shows the top internal search key phrases. Like example, if in Amazon, during the festival season, many people will be searching dresses and most important items for the festival period. So that will be the top keywords which was searched during the festival period. Internal search data can yield an understanding of customer intent and help improve site experience. So why we are going with this internal search report is for the website owner to understand what customers is expecting, and based on that top priority top keywords, they can improve their website. For example, like I told, during the festival period, many will be purchasing dresses. So during the festival period, they can give some offers and or they can include more dresses in their website. So this is why they are doing this kind of internal search. They are increasing internal search optimization and they are understanding what customers are expecting. At least 10% of your website visitors are using internal searches to navigate the website. 2 to 5% of them are using that most navigational elements on the site, such as top navigation, left navigation, links to the body of pages. Internal search key phrases are wonderful, and it is the best way of understanding visitor intent. If you you can study them and figure out what your visitors are looking for and how you can help them find it better. You can study them and figure out what your customers are looking and finding better. Sorry, I have given it 2 times. And the next one is internal search data can provide great clues about what is broken about your site. When doing this kind of taking this kind of data, internal search data report, they can identify what is missed out in their website. So for example, it provides clues about navigation and links, stuff people can't find easily or content that is completely missing. For example, if you have a big honking, blinking button that reads subscribe newsletter, and yet that is your top key phrase, you might want to rethink the blinking button. So one website owner has to think whether that linking button has to be placed over there, or they can remove it. If one of the top five key phrases on your internal site search report is registered product and you don't offer registration, you can see that there is your customer demanding that you do. So in the top five list keyword, if you are finding something that a customer is trying to purchase something on your website, but that option is not available for them. So in that case, if many customers are wanting to purchase that, then you can provide that option to customer. So it is hard enough for prospective visitors to find your website. If you somehow they try to find your website, measuring and optimizing internal searches is one of the key mechanisms by which you can improve customer satisfaction and improve your conversion rates. Measuring and subsequently optimizing your internal search consists of performing six discrete tasks. So the below are the we will go through each task one by one. First one is spot internal search trends. The most obvious way to use the data from your internal search engine is to gather insights into the user of your website's search feature and the keywords or phrases that your website visitors are using to find what they are looking for. And the next one is measure internal site search usage metrics. Use your web analytics tool or the software that came bundled with your internal search engine to measure internal searches. Most bundled reports from internal search tools report instances of keyword search and not visitors searching. They can be different metrics. So different metrics can be used to identify what visitors are searching. Instead of that, this internal search usage trends report will show you how many instances of keyword has been appeared. So in this example, you can see there are on November 1st, 322 visitors reached that website, and in which internal search users are only 6. And if you see November 4th, 143 visitors has reached that website, but internal search users count is 0. Next one is report on the top internal site search key phrases. At least the website owner, on a weekly basis, they have to review the top 25 key phrases from their internal search report. They need to, based on the key phrases, for content that they will have to actually prominently whether the keywords are displayed, or a customer is not able to find out that particular keyword in that website. For example, when sometimes when we are searching window coverings in the website of Amazon, but that won't be available in that website. But when Amazon owner trying to do this such kind of report, they can see multiple search for window coverings, but that is not available on the website. Instead of that, they have given the product name as curtains. Okay, so so this is just because of the different name they have used in their website, they will lose that customer. So they, once they do this kind of searching, they can actually change the naming of the product name with the high number of keyword, and they can increase the customers by that. It is extremely beneficial to look at key phrases that are returning no results on your website. This could alert you to spelling mistakes or terms that your users are using that you did not anticipate. Next one is analyze click density by using the site overlay report. So first, what is click density analysis? This is a tool which helps you to see if your visitors are clicking on what you want or clicking something else. This is the sample diagram on sample picture wherein click analysis report, how it will be looking like. In the top right, bottommost, you can see search, and you can see it is 15%. You can literally see customer clicks to your top keywords, and you can see whether customers think you are serving relevant results. 15% of those who saw the search results searched again. So when we might have gone through this kind of situation many times, we might be searching something in the Google, but we won't be able to. We actually held up on the same page many times, but we couldn't find that particular information what we were trying to find out. So when customer is checking this click density analysis, checking this click density analysis report using the overlay report, then they can improvise their website. The goal for internal site search results should be to have most of the click density clustered on the top 5 search results links, and no one should click next page. And next one is measure effectiveness of actual search results. You have figured out how many visitors are using your internal search engine, and you have also learned that keywords are being used to find relevant content. Now it is time to figure out whether the search results that are being returned are any good. From simply measuring, you step into driving change and action. Next one is measure the exit rate from the search results page. Using the overlay report, one can measure the exit rate from their internal search results page. Next one is measure effectiveness of synonyms or best bets. Synonyms are best bets. Best bets are links that appear on top of internal search results. These are created by the website owner as a helping hand for visitors. Best bets are created after analyzing what keywords are being used by visitors to the website and analyzing the site overlay report to understand click behavior and whether visitors are clicking on the most relevant links. These best bets provide a way to highlight superior results directly on top rather than relying solely on the mechanisms of your internal search engine. One can use site overlay report to analyze the effectiveness of these best bets and to optimize them over time. Next one is measure outcome metrics for internal searches. Because few site visitors will use any other feature to experience your website, it is important to measure outcome metrics for those visitors who use the internal search feature. Few may go through brands on the cart. Measuring they have to do. One is measure conversion rate. What is measure conversion rate is, if your internal search feature is working well, visitors using it will have higher conversion rates. If this is the case, you can use the data to justify more investment into optimal search technology. And next one is measure conversion, measure customer satisfaction. By getting feedback feedback from customer, one can do the customer satisfaction can be measured, whether they are happy with the website and how they can improve the website for them. And the overall hypothesis is that relevant search results equal to faster access to relevant data equal to higher customer satisfaction equal to a higher conversion, and that is equal to more money, and that is equal to higher bonus for you in your annual employee review. And the next one is SEO. SEO is search engine optimization. The keyword SEO returns 110 million results in 0.05 seconds on Google. The key phrase search engine optimization does not do that bad either. More than 39 million results in 0.08 seconds. According to Wikipedia, SEO as a subset of search engine marketing seeks to improve the number and quality of visitors to your website from natural search results. The objective in SEO is to improve the organic listing of a company's website pages for the keywords and key phrases that are most relevant to what the company does. Techniques applied in SEO efforts help improve the page rankings in various search engines. Each search engine has its own unique ranking methodology that is applied to any given website's pages, and when a user searches for a particular keyword or key phrase, the search engine applies that unique algorithm to return the most optimal results. Next, why the website vendor has to do the optimization. Understand the impact of optimization and the links. SEO strategy are the links that come from other sites to your site, the links that you have on your site, and how you code the links. The four big buckets in this category are as follows. Actually, when we are going through some blogs or some websites, we can see some links over there or something like click here. We can see such kind of things in that blog. So why we are having that? Relevant inbound links. Relevant inbound links are extremely important in computing the ranking of your page by major search engines. You can get free links, you can buy links, or you can exchange links with other websites with relevant content. Remember, that is relevant, that is very important. Next one is authoritative inbound links. Some links have more power than others. So links from the BBC or major web directories or the TDU domains have greater authority and hence more weight. Internal website links. It is optimal to cross-link the pages on your website and to link to relevant content deep within the website. Providing multiple paths into your website improves opportunity for spiders to crawl your website and index all the content, because most search spiders will go only three levels deep into website. Next one is anchor text. Links that have relevant text in the anchor will be more valuable. For example, if you link to your blog using some website, web analytics blog as the link text has more influence than click here link. Next is analyzing page per click effectiveness. PPC. Page per click means PPC stands for pay per click. A model of internet marketing in which advertisers pay a fee each time one is their ads is clicked. Essentially, it's a way of buying visits to your site rather than attempting to earn those visits organically. When marketers get together at parties, it is embarrassing for one to admit that he does not have a PPC campaign running at that very moment. marketers just jump in because it is so easy to do either by themselves or by sending money to an agency. It is also easy to show results because if you bid enough on your keywords, someone will click on their link and show up on the site. Let's take a step back and understand what a pay-per-click marketing is shows. The PPC results as they appear on most search results pages. In this picture, you can see the PPC results appear on the top. And to the right of the organic search results in almost all the search engines. The position of each PPC ad is determined by the amount that each advertiser bids in a dynamic marketplace. Understanding PPC basics. One of the biggest challenges of measuring end-to-end success for PPC campaigns is that for the most part, a keyword generation, keyword optimization, and keyword bidding strategy is outside the system, at least the system that you have access to, your web analytics tool. And there are a number of tools now in the market that have built-in data access to the search engine APIs that allow them to automatically download at least some core data from the search engines. These include campaign attributes, impressions, clicks, and cost per click at a minimum. Measure search engine bid related metrics for PPC. On the very first day's work, we'll focus on measuring the core metrics related to your keywords bidding. Here are the most important search engine bid related metrics. And the first one is page inventory, the number of available page slots for ads. Next one is impressions, the number of times the ad has been shown to your search engine visitor. Next is average position, the average rank at which the PPC ad was shown, usually a number between 1 to 1 and 8. Next is CPM, cost per 1000. Next is clicks, total clicks, CTR, click-through rate, CPC, cost per click. Next is campaign cost, CPC into clicks. Actually, you might have seen in Vishal sir YouTube video, there are a few ads coming up in every 5 minutes or so. Next topic is email marketing and multi-channel marketing. Email marketing fundamentals and a bit more. Every one of us are using email, and the blessing in terms of having changed our lives when it comes to communications. But nowadays, emails are being used for the marketing purpose also. In US, actually, every day a person is getting 15 marketing emails into trash or spam, and just because of that we are also actually missing some important mails. Why the marketers are using this in the last 10 to 15 years is to improve their marketing campaign portfolio. Understand email marketing fundamentals. Numerous studies from sources such as Forrester Research, Gartner, eMarketer, and the Direct Marketing Association consistently publish metrics indicating that email remains one of the most effective channels when it comes to marketing and ROI. Email communications are used by business for several purposes. They list down the below. Acquisition. Acquisition is finding the new customers. Next is increased sell through. Next is retention. Keeping the customers with them. Next is standard communications. Next point is to measure basic response metrics. Response metrics cover the initial part of the customer experience from when the email is sent to when the customer might come to the website. These metrics will hopefully lead to a win-to-win outcome for the customer and the marketing company. For optimal analysis of your email campaigns, you will be recording these important pieces of data. First is email sent, the number of emails that were sent to the customer. Next is email bounce, the number of emails that were simply bounced back because of bad email address or network problem, something like that. And email open, the number of emails that customers actually open. Next is unsubscribe. The number of email addresses those who were unsubscribed by the customers for that website. Next is clicks. The number of clicks that were generated after emails were opened. Think of these as being roughly equivalent to the web analytics visits metric. By using the above data, the email open, clicks, and unsubscribe, all of the above data, the vendor can create a little funnel that helps them visualize response effectiveness. Usually, you will also compute the following KPIs. Delivery rates, and then unsubscribe rate. Next is open rate, response rate. These are the details the vendor can arrive by using the data. Next one is measure outcome metrics. Focusing on measuring the effectiveness of your email campaigns in delivering for your company's bottom line. For each campaign, you will report on standardized metrics that you are already used to in your traditional web analytics world. The data that is used for this analysis is fairly standard. Outcomes, number of outcomes generated by the campaign, revenue metrics, and email conversion rates, revenue and average order size, revenue per email delivered. Okay, the one best practice tip when it comes to measuring outcomes is to create goals upfront for your campaigns. This seems rather obvious, but it is rarely done in most businesses. Asking for a goal is a great way to insert some discipline into the process, and of course, it is a great way to measure success and identify gaps in outcomes. Even if your conversion rate is 3%, knowing that your goal was 4% provides a different yardstick for declaring success. Okay, next topic is multi-channel marketing. Multi-channel analytics is more than a buzzword, and at its simplest, it is the art and science of measuring the impact of marketing efforts on multiple sales, customer, and contact channels. It is of vital importance and increasingly so with every passing day. However, anyone who says that they have a handle on multi-channel analytics is probably not stating the complete truth. Multi-channel analytics remains a challenge and an enigma. Any success that people have had measuring it is either a one-shot deal and are not repeatable, or it is not scalable. It is takes some time for the speech. And the next topic is segmentation. Segmentation is the process that segregates the data to find the actionable items. For example, you can categorize your entire website traffic data as one segment for a country and one for a specific city. In the picture, you can see three categories. People have been segmented in three categories. The first one is people bounced, and in the middle one is people only viewed the products, and the third one is people purchased the products. So these three categories, the customers have been segment that on the shopping cart. Next is data segmentation. Data segmentation is very useful to analyze website traffic. In analytics, you can analyze traffic insight with the help of segmentation. On the below picture, you can see how the segmentation can be added. And for a website, you can segment total traffic according to acquisition goals and channels. Following are the types of acquisition segmentation. Organic traffic, which was only the organic traffic of the website. You can find which search engine is working for you, either Google, Yahoo, Bing, etc. With the help of organic traffic, you can also find the top keywords that send traffic to your website. Next is referrals traffic. This segment shows the total referrals traffic of the website. With the help of this segment, you can find the top reference website that send traffic to your website. Next is direct traffic. This segment helps you to find the traffic that visits your website directly. Next is social traffic. With the help of social segment, you can analyze social traffic. How much traffic you are getting from social media, like Facebook, Twitter, Pinterest, etc. Is sending traffic to your website. With the help of this segment, you can make future social media strategy. For example, if Facebook is sending the highest traffic to your website, you can improve the Facebook post frequency. Like we are seeing some ads in the Facebook in the right side. If you are searching some books in the Google, then immediately when you open a Facebook, it will show you that books in the side corner of the ad frame. Next one is paid traffic. Paid traffic segment captures traffic through paid channels. When you are done with your segments, then the next step is analysis. Analysis is all about finding the actionable item from the data. So now we have segmented the customers based on their data, or from where they have landed up to the respective vendor website. So based on this data, the owner of the website can do some action on it. If you see this statistics report, for organic, from Jan month it is 40,000, and in the September month it is increased to 60,000. For referrals, it is increased by it is 5k, and in the mid of May you can see it is increased till 6k, but in the September it is decreased to 4k. Through the social website, initially it is 1k, and at the end of September it is increased to 4k. So from the above table, you can see your organic traffic is growing from 40 to 60,000. So, and then social reference also has been increased, but reference is decreased. From the social traffic, the vendor can actually dig through the analysis, and they can find out which social platform is helping them to increase their productivity. This is all about segmentation, and the next topic is competitive intelligence. What is competitive intelligence? Simply, it is the process of collecting and analysis information about your competitors, industry, and marketing environment. Today, the variety of marketing search tools and techniques is around the world. With them, you can dig into your competitor strategies and make marketing decisions based on valuable data. What is the long-term benefits of competitive intelligence? Understand better your competitors and thus stay ahead of them. Be more nimble and react quickly to your competitors' actions. Learn from successes and failures in the market. Target the right market segments and attract qualified customers. Avoid pitfalls and innovate successfully, get the inspiration for new ways to grow your business. There are a few competitive techniques, competitive intelligence techniques available in the market. In this picture, you can see a few of them. Research by social media posts, evaluate the content on the competitor website, break down your competitor's pricing. So few of them are, few of the techniques are posted here. Competitive intelligence tools give you a snapshot into a competitor's digital marketing strategy, including how they execute search engine optimization, social media strategy, advertising, and content marketing. They provide insight into where your competitors are succeeding. So you can learn from those successes. They show you where your competitors fail so you can avoid the same mistake. They show you where your competitors haven't gone yet, so you can plan new territory. So in this picture, you can see the competitors benchmark your website against competitors. There are a few competitors are available here. SpyFew for search engine and PPC keyword. SpyFew is a keyword search and tracking tool that can competitively price for small and medium sized businesses. In addition to finding keyword ideas for both AdWords and organic search and monitoring keywords for your domains, you can set up projects monitoring groups of keywords for ranking, ROI, and traffic profile performance. This is one of the sample for SpyFew. Next is Semrush has many users, but analyzing your competitor's PPC strategy is one of its most valuable. Its advertising research tool looks at competitor PPC spend to help you gauge what kind of budget you would need to match or beat them, and it is even shows you budget seasonality, so you know during which times of the year your competitors devote the most money to certain PPC strategies. Of course, the tool lays out which keywords are in play and how much they cost per click. So this picture displays the above. One, as you try to develop content ideas for your blogs, social posts, and media, it is often good to see what audiences are engaging with most frequently and what publishing strategies are working for your competitors. With free tools from Buzzsumo, you can search for key terms and see the most frequently shared content related to those terms, and you can filter your search by time period to see both what's performed best over time and to discover recently published high performance content. So this is one of the sample for web content search in the website. Next one is Web Analytics 2.0. Web analytics is the analysis of qualitative and quantitative data from your website and the competition. It is to drive a continual improvement of the online experience of your customers and prospects, which translates into your desired outcomes online. Web analytics 2.0 is a three-tier data delivery and analysis service for small and big businesses. And the first is the data itself, as it measures the traffic, page views, clicks, and more for both your website and for your direct competition. And the second is what you do with that data, or how you are able to take the information gathered via these services and apply it to your customers, whether new or existing, to make their experience meaningful and better. And the last one is the last tier is how it all circles back together to meet your overarching business objectives, not just online but offline as well. And this one is the Web Analytics 2.0. Here you can see lead circle representing a key component of what your Web Analytics strategy should be, regardless of what your size is. It approximately represents the amount of data that you will have access to as you try to find insights or correlations. This will display what is happening on my website, what are the outcomes, why it is happening, competitor analysis, what action should I take, like this.